When is the best time of the day to dedicate to your language studies? Are you having trouble focusing when you're engaging with your target language, or do you feel like the information that you're acquiring is not sticking as it should? Hey guys, xin chào. What's going on? This is Adan Sensei, your personal language coach, where I bring you my best tips and tricks for you to start building your power habits to improve your language skills and your learning mindset. On today's video, I want to focus on giving you some key distinctions on what time of the day to study at, or more importantly, the importance of your energy levels when you're engaging with your target language. Do you feel tired or like your studies are not going as smooth as they should? Maybe you feel like the information you are trying to absorb doesn't stick. You basically might just have a simple focus or energy problem. This might seem obvious for some people, but for someone that is having trouble absorbing difficult or challenging material, the following tips might help you to get the most out of your study sessions. I'm really into productivity, learning how to learn, and personal development. So the following are some techniques that I have picked up from these areas along the years. Let's check them out. Tip number one, study during your golden time. When you wake up in the morning, your brain is fully rested. Hopefully, after you finish your morning routine, if getting good at your language is a high priority for you in your life and you got some time to invest, dedicate this time to your language studies. You'll be able to absorb the information much easier and you will have tackled an important task at the beginning of your day. I personally like to do my Anki repetitions first thing in the morning while walking around in my room right here. I add about 10 minutes of meditation with breathing exercises and also about 15 to 30 minutes of reading to put something good in my mind and start from a good place. This year, by just doing this one habit alone, I was able to set the foundation to burn through my Mandarin and Portuguese Anki deck that has about 3,000 sentences in it, all in about 8 months. Not too shabby. Tip number two, cut your study sessions into 25-minute chunks and 5-minute breaks, especially for really challenging materials or materials that are giving you a hard time to start engaging with them. This comes from a technique called the Pomodoro technique. You basically set a timer on your smartphone, PC, or an actual physical timer, a kitchen timer. You cut out all distractions and you focus intently for 25 minutes on your studies or your target task. By doing this, I slice through my target material like butter and I get more done more consistently. For really challenging tasks though, you might want to leave it at 25 minutes. But for things that you don't have trouble starting, you can definitely go above 50-minute sessions as well. Adjust accordingly to the difficulty of your task at hand. Tip number three, study after a small power nap. Okay, so if you can't study in the morning, then whenever you get a chance, before you start engaging with your target material, take a small nap and then focus on your studies. You will be fresh and ready to tackle your challenge with a lot more energy. I do this when I've had a long and busy day of work and then I have a challenging task coming right after that. Try to be careful and not sleep above 20 minutes though, as this might affect your ability to sleep deep at night. To do this, sometimes you might want to schedule your timer and keep it away from you so that it forces you to stand up and go turn it off. Be careful not to leave it really close to you as you might just unconsciously turn it off and doze back again to sleep. This is very dangerous. If you sleep for more than 25 minutes, you might end up feeling even worse. You'll feel groggy and it'll probably affect your sleeping cycle at night as well. Tip number four, study after you have had cardio exercises. If you like working out, then aim to study after something that is related to cardio. After the movement, you will have oxygenated your whole body and you will have tremendous focus and energy as long as you don't overkill yourself in the workout. Exercise is generally linked to better learning, so this will definitely help you engaging much, much more actively in your study sessions. All right, amigos, that was all for today. Question of the day. When do you usually like to study or tackle your challenging tasks? Do you have any techniques that you want to share? Leave us a comment with your question or opinions in the box below. Alright, amigos, that was all for today. This was Adan Sensei, your personal language coach. Even the most demanding tasks can be handled by proper energy management and task chunking. Remember, though, to set up your environment so that it promotes focus. Remove all distractions from it, study when you are at the freshest, and I'll see you in the next video.